Jays. Hey, folks, stop what you're doing. I want you to take a good look at our set right now. It is time for our Behind the Badge segment. And this is big because this is the Women in Metro edition. We have LaToya Holman. You've seen her on our show before. She's a community outreach manager for the Las Vegas Metro Police Department Foundation. And she brought a few friends along. So, ladies, I'm going to call your name. I want you to raise your hand because I want everybody to know who you are. So, Captain Roxanne Burke. Captain Nita Schmidt, Captain Sasha Larkin, picking up what I'm putting down, and Captain Jamie Prosser, who just became a captain 2 weeks ago. So congratulations, and a big congratulations to Metro. And this is a big deal.
Because it's a huge deal.
It's a huge deal, LaToya, because Metro, never in the history have you had this many female captains or female leadership officers, right? This is so cool. And this isn't all of them, folks. There are like eight. There's eight altogether. LaToya, I want to start with you because I'm so excited about this. My sister is chief of police for Winston-Salem, North Carolina. So I know the struggle to get to that position.
And thank her for her service, please.
Yeah, and thank you guys for this. Okay, let's start out with the Wonder Women of Metro. It's an event coming up. I'm emceeing that event. Talk about it for
me. Yes, thank you for emceeing. So the Wonder Women of Metro, it's a luncheon that we're doing twice a year. It's at Neiman Marcus. It's next Thursday. Mm-hmm. And there's tickets still available, actually. And so really the whole point is to talk about the diversity and empowering women to be at their very best, their
Absolutely.
Best potential, and to really kind of show the Wonder Women and what can actually be achieved when you do that.
Yeah.
Diana Bennett is introducing our keynote speaker, who is Chris Ingolstadt McGarry this year.
I know both
and
of
so
those ladies.
It's just going to be a very powerful room in terms of the different kinds of women that are there and the different subjects that will be discussed. So a lot of girl power.
Okay, let's get down to it. Ladies, anybody can take the mic and just answer the questions, whoever's wants to get on the mic. Talk about what has happened here in your department, how you guys have experienced, you know, coming up through the ranks, and what have you noticed in terms of the change in culture in the civilian sector as it affects you?
Well, since you handed me the mic, I think we've all had mentors throughout our career that kind of encouraged us to go to the leadership side of Metro.
Mm-hmm.
And without our mentors, I don't think any of us would be here. And I know that it's all been instilled upon us to mentor the other female on the department and, you know, all of our officers, but we certainly gravitate towards other females that can be great leaders.
Yeah.
I think that as Las Vegas and our valley, we very community oriented and we're very used to seeing female officers and the ones that are out there doing the real work, and there are real boots on the ground.
Yeah.
But as we move up in rank, we get fewer and fewer. So I think we've impacted dramatically the community, seeing that we currently have 8 female captains, which is the largest Metro seen in their history.
I love it.
So I'm being the only captain for almost 2 years. When I got promoted, I was the one that stood out, which was great. And I'm just so happy and so proud to be joined by so many other women, so many smart and talented women that give a different perspective. And we have wonderful male counterparts in the same positions. But I think it's important for us to bring all the different unique skills.
We like
that
them, but we want to see y'all too. Sorry, Captain Clark, or Sergeant Clark is here too. Sorry, Jeff, you have to stay over there for now. But listen, I want to ask you also, how are young girls reacting to you guys when you're out in the field? What do you get? Because I know you go to schools and all that kind of stuff. Talk about that part for us. Anybody?
Well, just really quick before I hand it back to Sasha and Jamie, there was one time I was a captain over the Enterprise Area Command, and we had a Girl Scout troop come in and do a tour. And I went in and talked to them, and when they explained that I was the boss at the station, all of these girls were just completely enamored, like, oh my goodness.
A girl,
you know,
can
they
do
didn't.
It.
Yeah, they kept looking around at the men, like who was in charge and who was the boss. So it was just amazing that it kind of motivated them to be able
That's
to do
yeah,
what they
absolutely.
Wanted at such
absolutely.
A young age.
Talk about that same thing. Yeah.
Well, I'd like to point out that in addition to this job, we also have our real job at home.
Yes.
All of us are
gosh.
Mothers. In fact, I believe we all are mothers to daughters.
Yeah. Yes.
And it's impactful, and it's
that's huge.
It's huge to watch how your children view you.
Yeah.
And especially just recently promoting, and to see how proud my children were, my daughters.
Yeah.
Of me becoming successful. It's just, it's humbling.
Well, guys, you're going to stick around for a Facebook Live. We're out of time, but I just want everybody to see this. Metro is doing this, and thank you to Joe Lombardo. He's been on our show before, too. Hopefully, we can get these numbers increased, because girls need to see more of this. Yes, hashtag time's up. I love it. Wonder Women of Metro, the event is coming up on May 17th. We'll keep you posted on that. Stay with us, everybody. We'll be right back. Girl power!